Oh boy, I don't really know where to start with this one. So back in January or February, I made a few videos on the Penguins and how despite making trades where they trade away future prospects and draft picks, I was still kind of optimistic about their future post-prime Crosby and Malkin. But now, half a year later, my view on the Penguins and their future has changed, and it's all because of this trade, which brings Kasperi Kapanen back to the Penguins in exchange for the first round draft pick this year, which was at 15th overall, and Swedish forward prospect Filip Hollander. So I'll just say this to start, I do not understand this trade in the bigger picture. And when I look at the Penguins, they don't need forwards, and while Kapanen won't be someone who you rely on for your offensive output, he's a two-way player who can play on the PK, but I don't see the Penguins being in dire need of a player like this. For me, their problems lie in their defense, and especially in Jack Johnson and Justin Schultz. And speaking of Jack Johnson, who we know has been terrible, and it was even more apparent in the play-in series against Montreal, when I saw the return the Leafs were getting before we had the full trade details, I was almost sure the Penguins were sending Jack Johnson the other way, but nope, just a 15th overall pick, a great prospect, and Evan Rodriguez, who is, he's okay, I guess. So the Penguins, in my opinion, massively overpaid. You know, the 15th overall pick for Kapanen straight up might have been okay. And for the Pens, it would make sense in the short term. You get a player who is already established in the NHL, he's good right now, he's young, and you can throw him on a line with Crosby or Malkin and see what happens. It doesn't always work out, but it's worth a shot. But my question is this, how much will Kapanen really improve? In a one-for-one trade with the first round pick, this would have been acceptable. Still a bit of an overpay, but acceptable. He can blossom out and playing with Crosby and Malkin, and if it can happen like I said. But throwing in Filip Hollander, who for me is probably the second or third best prospect in a, let's be honest, pretty weak Penguins prospect pool, just does not make sense at all. He had a good season in the SHL, and while I don't think he's going to be a consistent top 6 forward in the NHL, the Penguins can afford to trade away what little they have in terms of top prospects in their organization, and I was already worried about their prospect pool when they traded away Kalen Addison in the Jason Zucker trade, and now getting rid of a good forward prospect while not having a first round pick in this year's draft and the 2021 draft, yeah, I'm not too optimistic about their future post Crosby and Malkin. Of course, just because you have a first round pick doesn't mean you're going to strike gold in the mid first round. You can get lucky and snag yourself a Matt Barzal or like last year a Cole Caulfield, but the Penguins have been so dialed in on competing and winning cups since, well, Crosby came in. And that is totally understandable, and I've supported and understood the trades they made with their first round picks in the past, except for the Ryan Reeves trade, and that's when it started going downhill for me, but overall, the trades they made have made sense and they won cups doing it. But now, this is just an overpay, and the Penguins window won't be open for much longer, and I don't think Kapanen is the final piece that will win them a cup. And they need defense more than they need offense, so yeah, we'll see what happens. I'll say this though, I don't think the Penguins are done with their trades for the offseason. Matt Murray is probably still getting traded, and if they don't get a defenseman in that trade, then I don't know what to do. Anyways, enough ranting about the Penguins and what their future kind of looks like, let's take a look at what this means for the Leafs, who are the big winners in this trade. They free up cap space, they get a first round pick, which they didn't have, and they get good prospects overall. This is a great trade for Dubas. The interesting question for me is who the Leafs will use their 15th overall pick on, and I'm almost 100% certain it will be on a defenseman. Braden Schneider and Caden Gooley are names I've seen been thrown around, and out of those two, I would probably go with Schneider, seeing how he's a right-handed defenseman, and while he won't have an immediate impact on the NHL squad, he's still good to have in your system. On the forward side, we have Seth Jarvis, who is ranked around 15th, and while he would be a fun pickup, it's not what the Leafs need, but I don't know, maybe they'll go with him. There's also the chance that goaltender Yaroslav Askarov is available at 15th, and they might want to take a chance on him and see where that goes, but I think a defenseman is the number one priority for the Leafs in the draft. Anyways, that was my analysis, my rant, discussion, whatever you want to call it about the Kasperi Kapanen trade. As you might understand, I'm not a huge fan of it for the Penguins, but for the Leafs, this is a great trade. And yeah, I guess it's trade season for the eliminated teams, which is great fun. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.